The history of the destruction of Bel and the Dragon. And King Astyages was gathered to his fathers, and Cyrus of Persia received his kingdom. And Daniel conversed with the king, and was honored above all his friends. Now the Babylonians had an idol called Bel, and there were spent upon him every day 12 great measures of fine flour, and 40 sheep, and 6 vessels of wine. And the king worshipped it, and went daily to adore it. But Daniel worshipped his own power. And the king said unto him,
Why dost thou not worship Bel?
Who answered and said,
Because I may not worship idols made with hands, but the living power who hath created the heaven and earth, and hath sovereignty over all flesh.
Then said the king unto him,
Thinkest thou not that Bel is a living god? Seest thou not how much he eateth and drinketh every day?
Then Daniel smiled and said,
O king, be not deceived, for this is but clay within and brass without, and it never eat or drink in vain.
So the king was wroth and called for his priests and said unto them,
If ye tell me not who this is that devoureth these expenses, ye shall die. But if ye can certify me that Bel devoured them, then Daniel shall die.
For he had spoken blasphemy against Bel.
Hold up.
Because he's special, huh?
And Daniel said unto the king,
Let it be according to thy word.
Now the priests of Bel were 70 beside their wives and children. And the king went with Daniel into the temple of Bel. So Bel's priest said,
Lo, we go out, but thou, O king, set on the meat. Make ready the wine, and shut the door fast, and seal it with thine own signet. And tomorrow, when thou comest in, if thou findest not that Bel hath eaten up all, we will suffer death, or else Daniel that speaketh falsely against us.
And they little regarded, for under the table they had made a privy entrance, whereby they entered in continually, and consumed those things. But when they were gone forth, the king set meats before Bel. Now, Daniel had commanded his servants to bring ashes, and those they strewn throughout all the temple in the presence of the king alone. Then went they out and shut the door and sealed it with the king's signet, and so departed. Now, in the night came the priests with their wives and children, as they were wont to do, and did eat and drink of all.
Oh my gosh! The nectar!
In the morning betime, the king arose and Daniel with him. And the king said,
Daniel, are the seals whole?
And he said,
Yea, O king, they be whole.
And as soon as he had opened the door, the king looked upon the table and cried with a loud voice,
Great art thou, O Bel, and with thee is no deceit at all.
Then laughed Daniel and held the king that he should not go in and said,
Behold now the paper, and mark well whose footsteps are these.
And the king said,
I see the footsteps of men, women, Children? Women? Men!
And then the king was angry.
I'll put you in the ground where you belong.
And took the priests with their wives and children.
Get over here!
Who showed him the privy doors, where they came in and consumed such things as were upon the table.
You brought this on yourself. Your reign is over.
I would rather die by your hand than the prophets.
Therefore the king slew them and delivered Bel into Daniel's power, who destroyed him and his temple. And in that same place, there was a great dragon, which they of Babylon worshipped. And the king said unto Daniel,
Wilt thou also say that this is a brash? Lo, he liveth, he
eat it and drink it. Thou canst not say that he is no living God, therefore worship him.
Then Daniel said unto the king, I will worship the Most High my power, but give me leave, O king. I shall slay this dragon without sword or staff, for he is the living power.
The king said,
I give thee leave.
Then Daniel took pitch and fat and hay, and did seed them together, and make lumps thereof. This he put in the dragon's mouth, and so the dragon burst asunder. And Daniel said, Look, these are the gods that you worship.
Yodor Ahayah!
When they of Babylon heard that,
Daniel has slain Bel.
Daniel has slain Bel.
They took great indignation and conspired against the king, saying,
The king has become a Jew, and he hath destroyed Bel. He hath slain the dragon and put the priest to death.
So they came to the king and said,
Deliver us, Daniel, or else we will destroy thee and thine house.
Dead!
Now when the king saw that they pressed him sore, being constrained, he delivered Daniel unto them, who cast him into the lion's den, where he was 6 days. And in the den there were 7 lions, and they had given them every day 2 carcasses and 2 sheep, which then were not given to them, to the intent that they might devour Daniel. Now there was in Jewry a prophet called Habakkuk, who had made pottage and had broken bread in a bowl, and was going into the field for to bring it to the reapers. But the angel of the Most High said unto Habakkuk, Go, carry the denture that thou hast into Babylon unto Daniel, who is in the lion's den. And Habakkuk said,
Lord, I never saw Babylon, neither do I know where the lion's den is.
Then the angel of the Lord took him by the crown, and bare him by the hair of his head, and through the vehemency of his spirit, set him in Babylon over the den. And Habakkuk cried, saying,
O Daniel, Daniel, take the dinner which Ahiah hath sent thee.
And Daniel said, Thou hast remembered me, O Ahiah, neither hast thou forsaken them that seek thee and love thee. So Daniel arose and did eat, and the angel of the Most High set Habakkuk in his own place again immediately. Upon the 7th day, the king went to bewail Daniel, and when he came to the den, he looked in, and behold, Daniel was sitting. Then cried the king with a loud voice, saying,
Great art thou, O Most High Power of Daniel, and there is none other besides thee.
And he drew him out,
Not up in here,
and cast those that were the cause of his destruction into the den. And they were devoured in a moment before his face.
Flawless victory.